show you how it was transformed. A person said once, "It sounds like a tiger howling." I said, "Fine." To myself, I said, "That's the name." So I'll play it for you. We'll say that's a plenty. That's a plenty. No, we won't say that. We'll say Panama. That was a very good hot number, and we played it pretty good around there. Thank you. same principles. I will play a little number now of the slower type to give you an idea of the slower type of jazz music, which you can apply to any type tune that depends upon your ability for transformation. Sweet jazz music. I don't have any name for it. Just a number that I just thought I'd play a while here, just to give a person a good idea. Riffs, what you call riffs in the jazz, you know, in the slow tunes. I've seen this blundered up so many times it has given me the heart failure. No, I haven't got a drum. That's my foot, if you happen to think of something like that. Thank you.
involved.
You know the words and all that?
No, that wasn't mentioned in there. Yeah, no, it's a salty dog. Old salty dog. Old salty dog. Old salty dog. That's about all the names. That's all the words it was. Old salty dog. Old salty dog.
City Stomp. You may notice that in playing jazz, the breaks are one of the most essential things that you can ever do in jazz. Without breaks, and without clean breaks, without beautiful ideas and breaks, you don't need to even think about doing anything else. If you can't have a decent break, you haven't got a jazz band, or you can't even play jazz.
Show us a good break, Jelly.
That's what you call a pretty good break. For instance, I'd play just a little bit of melody or something and show you.